It's time for more wholesome Guda Guda fun. Hello everyone, Sober Oni of G&D Reviews here, and today we'll be taking a look at the only Guda Guda servant who doesn't have cute feet, Hijikata Toshizo. We'll be examining his stats and skills, as well as going over pointers on how to utilize him effectively, and an overall grade comparing him to how he stacks up to the other 5-star servants. Now, onto Hijikata's stats. Hijikata has a max HP of 12,208 and a max attack of 12,089, which actually becomes 13,297 due to his Berserker class modifier. When compared to his fellow Berserkers, he has the lowest HP among all 5-star Berserkers, but pretty high attack, ranking only below Kintoki and Ku Alter. Likewise, compared to the other 5-star servants, his attack is very high, while his HP is near the absolute bottom. Overall, this is exactly the kind of stat you would expect from a Berserker, and a perfect stat line for a glass cannon. Taking a look at his skills, his first skill is Demon of the Battlefield rank B. It increases his Buster card effectiveness for 3 turns between 10 and 20%, and it also increases his crit star drop rate for 3 turns between 10 and 20%, both depending on level. His second skill is Disengage rank C. It removes all debuffs and restores between 500 and 1500 HP depending on level. And finally, his last skill is Kyokuchu Hato rank EX. It increases his crit star gather rate for 3 turns between 2000 and 4000% depending on level. It also increases his crit strength depending on how low his HP is for 3 turns, and it comes with a demerit that decreases your HP by 1000. Moving on to his passives, Hijikata only has one, and it is Madness Enhancement rank D+. It increases his Buster card effectiveness by 5%. Taking a look at his deck and Noble Phantasm, Hijikata has a Quick Buster deck with Quick Quick, Arts, Buster Buster, and a Buster Noble Phantasm. His Noble Phantasm is Shinsengumi. It deals significant damage to a single enemy with between a 600% and 1000% damage modifier, and the damage increases as his HP is lower, increasing with overcharge between 600 and 1000%. And this Noble Phantasm can be upgraded through an interlude, which will increase the damage modifier to between 800 and 1200%, and will also increase the bonus modifier that depends on overcharge and HP to between 800 and 1200%. Taking a closer look at his cards, we see that his quick card hits 3 times, his arch card hits twice, his buster hits twice, and his extra attack hits 3 times. He has an NP gain rate of 1.08% and a star rate of 4.9%. He does have good NP gain for a Berserker thanks to the double quick cards and arts, but low star generating overall because of the low hit counts and star rate. Hijikata packs some high level stats for a Berserker, specifically boasting some high attack. His deck is atypical of a Berserker, but it does allow him to get some good NP gain, at least by Berserker standards. But let's address the elephant in the room. Hijikata relies heavily on a gimmick, and that gimmick is being able to deal more damage at lower HP, much like Anne and Mary. Also much like Anne and Mary, he is crit-based. His third skill, Kyokuchu Hato, will give you a massive boost to star weight and a variable boost to your crit damage based on how low your HP is at the cost of 1000 HP. At max HP, this skill is going to give you a 20% crit damage buff, while at 1 HP, you're going to get a 100% crit damage buff. Practically speaking, you're going to want to be at least 60% HP before you activate this skill, because that's when the buff becomes worth it. It'll grant you 50% crit damage, much like the self-modification and Demon King skills that Jolter and Nobunaga have. The HP demerit on the skill can be counteracted by Hijikata's second skill, Disengage. This heals him for a very minor amount and removes any debuffs. Debuff removal is very useful to have for any challenge content. And finally, Hijikata also has a small buster buff in Demon of the Battlefield. This skill also buffs his star generating, but that's irrelevant as even with this buff, Hijikata's star generating is lackluster. The buster buff is very small, but it does have a low cooldown, so you can keep it active for most of the fight and give even your non-Noble Phantasm attacks a nice kick. Skill priority for Hijikata is Kyokuchu Hato first to ensure that you can gather the crit stars you need, followed by Demon of the Battlefield for the damage buff, and then Disengage last as the heal is very minor. If you don't plan on using Hijikata in a crit team at all, then go for Demon of the Battlefield first instead. Hijikata's Noble Phantasm is a single target buster attack that deals additional bonus damage depending on how low your HP is. In addition, there is an interlude for the Noble Phantasm further down the line, buffing its damage considerably. But of course, to maximize the damage, you're going to want to only use this when you're at low HP. And when you do, you can put out astronomically high damage numbers. As you can see, Hijikata is a servant that excels when he is on the edge of his life. Under the right circumstances and the right setup, his single turn burst damage can be among the highest in the game, ideal for his role as a berserker. But of course, it's never as easy as press a button and win the game. Unless you're Merlin. Just because Hijikata has the potential to be godlike doesn't mean he has the practicality. And that is Hiji's major weakness. He is simply too inconsistent to make effective use of his gimmick. For one thing, the concept of becoming stronger at lower HP doesn't work as well for berserkers as it does for every other class, because berserkers are prone to blowing up instantly from 2-3 hits or an unlucky crit, because they're weak to every class. There is no safe way of getting Hijikata's HP low enough since he doesn't have guts built into his kit. His disengage skill is also laughably underwhelming. A 1.5k heal on a berserker is almost nothing, and while debuff removal is good, it isn't what he needs. So overall, Hijikata's low HP mechanic is unreliable, and this wouldn't be as much of a problem if he didn't depend on it completely to deal any real damage, but unfortunately he does. Because of his lack of a full buster deck and a very small buster buff, his damage is unimpressive if he's at full or near full HP, and many 4-star berserkers are going to easily outdamage him. Hijikata has no way of safely lowering his own HP, and while there are craft essences that can grant you guts that can help you, you're going to run into issues with possibly dying before you charge your Noble Phantasm to full. So one craft essence isn't enough to fix the inconsistency issue. In other words, to get value out of Hijikata, he needs an entire team built around his gimmick. There are two ways to build a team with Hijikata, traditional or gimmicky. A traditional berserker build would just be surrounding him with buffers and trying to maximize his damage that way without relying on trying to lower his HP. This kind of team is much more consistent and low risk, but it's also a lot weaker. If this is your preferred method, then I suggest using servants like Helena, Leonidas, and Shakespeare. Helena's buff applies to all command cards, which helps Hijikata since his deck isn't as buster oriented as other berserkers, and she also has an NP battery skill. Shakespeare is also good for similar reasons. He has an NP battery and a buster buff for your Noble Phantasm, and finally, Leonidas can give you a small buster buff while also protecting you with his taunt to give you a lot more breathing room. You can also build a gimmicky team that is focused around keeping Hijikata alive at low HP for as long as possible. This kind of team is very high risk, high reward, and in my opinion, it's much more fun to play. You'll need to depend on servants that can give you guts, so the best teammates are Iris Veel, Quetzalcoatl, and Romulus. Iris Veel is very self-explanatory, she can grant you guts very quickly and very often, but she also has healing, which is a big downside in this case. Quetzalcoatl and Romulus both have a targetable guts and buster buff, so they're going to be perfect for setting you up for a big turn of damage with your Noble Phantasm. Hijikata's bond craft essence is Haori of Os. It grants him guts for one time and increases his NP damage by 30%. This is the best possible craft essence for Hijikata, and it buffs him significantly, much like Hurt's bond craft essence does. And I highly recommend using it once you get it. But until then, you're going to want to use general damage buffing craft essences if you're using him in a traditional team. Craft essences like Black Grail, Castle of the Sun, and Limited Zero. Black Grail has the benefit of lowering your HP and making your Noble Phantasm tremendously strong. Limited Zero and other buster buffing craft essences help out your overall damage, and Castle of the Sun is great if you're going to make use of your crit skill. If you're using Hijikata in a gimmicky team, then you're going to want craft essences that provide guts or a taunt to ensure that you're targeted. Star of Arturia, Princess of the White Rose, Kaldia Lifesavers, and Guda Poster Girl are all ideal for doing just that. For future-proofing, I recommend Two Gods, Three Legs. This is essentially a slightly weaker version of your Bondcraft Essence. It boosts your NP damage by 15% and gives you Guts for one time. Overall, Hijikata does have unique skills and gameplay for a Berserker. He has the potential to do big damage, and he is a great crit Berserker, but he is greatly crippled by his own gimmick. Without a very specific team built around him, he's going to underperform compared to other 5-star and even 4-star Berserkers. He is not self-sufficient at all, and even with the proper team and craft essences, he's still very difficult to use effectively and too reliant on RNG. So he gets a C from me. Provided you have the exact type of team to support his gimmick, he can be strong, but still insanely high risk. And if you don't have that type of team, which is most people, he's going to perform like a very below average Berserker. And those are my thoughts on Hijikata. I should also note that he does have some incredible animations though. But as always, let me know what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to leave a like if you enjoyed the video, and consider subscribing if you really enjoyed the video. Join the party over at our Discord, chill with us on Twitch, and follow us on Twitter. And I will see you all in the next Servant Spotlight. Soberoni out. Later.